Warning, this reaction uses irritants and corrosive chemicals. This should be performed with gloves outside or in a fume hood. Greetings fellow nerds, in this video we're going to make fluorescein, a strongly fluorescent chemical. First we get 166 milligrams of phthalic anhydride and add to it 220 milligrams of resorcinol. Then we add on top a few drops of sulfuric acid. Now we gently heat the mixture until it turns a dark red brown. You may have to stir it around a bit to get it mixed. Keep heating it at around 200 degrees Celsius for about 5 minutes. What's happening is the phthalic anhydride and the resorcinol are reacting to form fluorescein. The sulfuric acid is acting as a catalyst for this reaction. When it's done, turn off the heating and let it cool down to room temperature before handling it. Here we are. Add in 10 milliliters of water. Fluorescein isn't very soluble in water, so we also add in some sodium hydroxide, about 300 milligrams, and shake. Now we have a solution of fluorescein. To test it, we put a few drops in water under ultraviolet light. And there it is. Let's try that again, but without the background sign. You might be asking why the concentrated solution doesn't also glow under ultraviolet light. That's because it's so concentrated that it absorbs and quenches its own fluorescence. A dilute solution doesn't do that. Let's do this one last time close up. Wow, this is better than a lava lamp. And that is fluorescein. Thanks for watching. In this video, we're going to make cadmium selenide quantum dots, a type of nanoparticle with interesting properties. In this video, we're going to demonstrate temperature-sensitive fluorescence, also known as fluorescence thermochromism.